you think of somebody having arthritis, you normally think of someone older. Unfortunately, though, it affects kids, too. A lot of kids.
Zachary Lampkin looks like a normal 7-year-old. That's because this is a good day. Too many days are not, like one in particular 4 years ago.
He went to bed perfectly fine and woke up the next morning and couldn't walk.
5 months and 17 doctor's appointments later, Zachary was diagnosed with juvenile rheumatoid arthritis. His parents were heartbroken.
There was a certain amount of relief because we finally knew what was wrong. But then it kind of sets in and, well, kids don't get arthritis. That's what older people get.
In fact, 300,000 kids a year are diagnosed with rheumatoid arthritis, robbing kids of some of the best parts of their childhoods.
I wanted to see him, you know, be that athlete, you know, like all dads do, and I was afraid that that would never happen. And not that I would think less of him or love him any less, but, you know, that's just something you look forward to enjoying.
Fortunately, Zachary is responding well to medication right now. It can always change, though.
Every 6 weeks, he goes to Brenner Children's Hospital for an IV infusion. We're there all day, and he just takes one medicine every morning now.
Zachary didn't want to talk on camera, but he is now raising money for the Juvenile Arthritis Foundation. He wants to help find a cure because, he says,
I don't want you to have it. I don't want anyone to have it. It's just not fair.
Yeah, and the one thing with the medication when you're dealing with juvenile arthritis or arthritis altogether is the medicine can work for a while, and then suddenly they can't find anything that works. And that's why it's so important to raise money. And Zachary is doing that, and we have a link to his website. It's in the Scene on 12 section of WXII12.com.
I had no idea. I read your story this morning before we went on the air. I had no idea 300,000 children have that, and apparently they develop almost an immunity to this medicine. Boy, poor parents. Glad he was having a good day there.
I know, and it just takes so long to get a diagnosis. And I mean, you know, they were worried that he had brain tumors, you name it.
17 doctor trips. Man,
goodness.
Oh, man.